Ethan, what are you doing here?
Well, I called your house and they said you were here.
Corey, are you okay? Beth said you weren't feeling well.
Oh, yeah, I don't know what hit me. Maybe I'm just coming down with something.
Well, I hope not. If we're gonna be getting married soon, we can't have you getting sick.
Well, I'm sure I will be fine. Oh, in no time.
You know, Beth said it was like you had morning sickness.
I mean, what a coincidence. You know, your friend Lynn said the same thing last night.
Oh, well, you know how people jump to conclusions. I mean, a woman gets sick and everybody assumes that she's pregnant.
Well, you are up early this morning.
Well, I was planning on going by the courthouse to pick up the marriage license, but I got a call from a potential client looking for an attorney.
Oh, gosh. That's wonderful news. That's exactly what you've been waiting for.
Yeah, I'm meeting with him in a little while, just right outside of town. Do you want to come with me after you finish breakfast?
Oh.
Really strange.
Yes.
You've been getting sick at the sight of food recently.
It's nothing.
Huh. Wait a minute. I was just thinking about what Lynn said last night about you being pregnant with Julian's baby. And don't you remember what Lynn said last night about you being pregnant with Julian's baby?
I remember.
Yeah, well, I can only imagine what she would think now if she found out you were sick again. You know, she'd be even more convinced that you were pregnant.
Oh, well, you know, who cares what Lynn says anyway, you know?
I don't care. I just think it's funny, that's all.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like she was determined to prove that you were pregnant. You know, if she saw you were drinking juice instead of coffee, she'd say you were avoiding the caffeine for the baby. Now, it was crazy of her to think you were pregnant. Especially with Julian's baby.
Yeah, that is the craziest idea.
It's just plain impossible. I mean, you would never have slept with Julian. And, you know, your marriage was an accident.
It's all an accident.
Yeah, I mean, and if you had, he would have told me, and then I would have killed him.
Honey, please don't talk like that.
Well, it's the truth. I mean, you would never willingly go to bed with Julian. He'd have to force himself on you. He'll take advantage of you. I couldn't let him get away with that.
Well, you know, there's no point in even talking about it anyway.
Right.
No, you're right, because it never happened. Right, Teresa? There are no more secrets between us. Sorry to leave you while you're not feeling well, sweetheart, but I need to get going.
Well, don't worry about me. Good luck with the client. Mm.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. This is the first step in getting my law practice up off the ground. Once I build up business and we get settled financially, I can start a family.
I want a family with you more than anything.
That goes for me, too. I can't wait for you to be pregnant for the first time. I want you to know I'm going to be there for you and our child the whole way through. But first, I better go see this client.
Okay.
Feel better, sweetheart? Mm-hmm.